Yo, what's up guys, it's the Lost Girl, welcome back to another video. Today's video, you know, just gonna be doing some whiz peeve. This is gonna be more of like, you know, just a commentary, chill video while I peeve, but like, I want your guys' opinion, you know, low-key. In case you're not the type of guy to watch these types of videos, I just wanna know, do you guys want me to focus more on PvP, as in, whenever I'm in a match, do you guys want me to be like, basically, focused the entire time, like, only focusing on what's happening in the game, or do you guys want me to discuss more general things? You know, talk more about things that are not like whiz. Maybe, you know, have some more interesting conversations, ask you guys some questions, ask for some input on certain things. Or do you guys want me to, like I said, just focus fully on PvP, you know, invest myself fully into it and make sure that I'm not like, you know, losing focus and playing at my best? I just want to hear what you guys have on that in the comments below. But, you know, besides that, I do want to discuss my current, you know, peeve strategy once I grab my jewels and stuff. I want to discuss my current peeve strategies for fire. Now, if you guys don't know, the best fires right now are fueling. And honestly, I'm not much of a trap sack type guy. I usually tend to avoid the trap sack side of things. It's usually just not fun for me. Regardless of if it's the best way to play a school or not, I just don't have much fun with it. So, you'll never really catch me doing that. But I do want to show you guys my setup that I've been actually making work pretty well for fire. Now, a lot of the fires were using Fire Wyvern at the time of making my video for my setup, and like, as much as it is a fun setup to use, I genuinely think Fire's best non-shad right now is Ifrit, and to use that to its best potential, you kind of need Pierce Enchant, because an open buffed Ifrit with Pierce Enchant does like literally like 3k. It's crazy, bro. Like, it's actually, it does literally just as much as a shad would, like as much as an FFA would, because you have the Pierce to make up for it. So in my opinion, right now, taking open buff Ifrit with Pierce Enchant is just as good as taking an FFA, because you get that weakness utility as well. So this is how basically I play fire. I just run Jhin's defense, use my elves to counter other people who are spamming set shields and stuff like that, get some damage up with heavy TCs and blades and all that, and I mean, it's worked pretty well for me, man. I'm actually getting a lot of success right now on fire, I'm not gonna lie. The only thing I'm kind of unsure about keeping in my deck is Oni's Projection. But I do strike decently often, especially against Ice and Balance, especially against Balance. So I've been kind of trying to hold on to my Oni's Projection to see if I can get any value out of it. But we're just going to send the match. Let's see how it goes. But in general, I just want to hear what you guys think about my commentary, what you guys want from me in terms of that. But let's see what you guys have to say about that. So good luck. So this looks like it's probably going to be a Mandar Myth. Oh, I keep forgetting you can't say anything in chat anymore. Also, let me know in the comments. I know I'm asking for a lot of things. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about the robe. Because the robe, I've been saying since the beginning, is gas, but everybody always hates on it. So let me know what you guys think. So I want to hold a Pierce Enchanted Ifrit in hand all of the early game. Because if this guy's Mandar, I want to make sure I get an open Ifrit that does mass on him first. I'm going to go in Sunblock. Make sure you can't Mandar me. I might honestly double Sunblock. If I pull another one, I'm just going to use it. Yeah, I'm just going to stun block again. I don't really care. Okay, really solid hand. I want to hold on to as many Ifrits as possible. Shield, okay, I'm just going to stun block again. I'd rather not get Mandar'd, I'm going to be honest. I'll just completely protect myself from that dumb shit. I'm going to try this strategy against Mandar. Just literally just getting 4 stun blocks up before he can even do anything. I'm going to keep up a reversal. Get rid of one Ifrit, I guess. Yeah, so he's just gonna get the frenzy off right now. Whatever, dude. So we're just gonna elf. We're just gonna elf, because obviously you don't wanna shield whenever he frenzies. You wanna get him open so you can trade a hit with him. So right now he's probably gonna Mandar. I'm gonna set shield. And then if he blades, I Ifrit or something like that, so he can't multi-hit me. Again, I'm fully expecting him to go for a hit soon, right? Yeah. He's gonna try to Mandar right now, right? Yeah, there he goes. There he goes, dude. The skill combo. Again, if he Mythic Fuels, I do have the reversal in hand, so I'll be fine if he does that. 700 damage, by the way. So right now my best option is definitely just a weakness, because he has a lot of multi-hit options as a Myth Wizard, so I need to make sure I pull my weaknesses and have that ready. Yeah, so we weakness him first. Because again, he does have a lot of multi-hit options, so I don't really want to mess with him on that regard. And I just wait till I have more pips so I can E-free him, right? Man, this is always a hard schooled out trade whenever they have Mandar. So you gotta play smart. So, yeah. He's doing some damage with Elf, I guess. Let's see what he does here. He's gonna White Rat Magician. That's a really well thought out move, actually. Low key. So, I think my best move here is definitely just set shield. Low key. His best move would be a Minnow, but if he Blades or something like that, I'm just gonna E-free, I think. So I'm gonna set shield. I'm really worried that he's gonna Minnow. If he Minnows, I might actually just lose. Low key, because a Minnow would do so much right now, and he'd still have plenty of pips left, so. I'm low key worried about that. Let's see what he does, though. I'm not sure. We'll see. I low key need a Heffy in hand, too. Or Steel Ward is kinda nice. Steel Ward is really nice. Basically, I just need to get some damage leverage up so I can like just completely shut him down after his frenzy thing goes away. Let's see what he does here. So he's gonna blade, isn't he? That's fine. That's fine. I'm actually just gonna E-free. I mean, I guess I could just fuel, right? Because he's not gonna shield, and if he does, I'll just Jin's defense. I'm worried about a Minnow, like I said. It's going to do mass, but I think an E-free would honestly do the same damage right now that a Minnow would. I'm also worried about a King Art. A King Art would be tough. I don't think I have a triage in hand either. Let's see what he does here. Okay, yeah, Minnow, well played. So he did end up Minnowing, which should do like 3.5, but my E-free does the same damage because I have a Pierce Enchant on. And I have the follow-up fuel. So let's see what he does here. So this is like, what, 3.1? 2.5. Okay, I mean, is this his last round? Wait, what? Okay, I mean, sure. I'll just take the open E-free. I just said that does literally the same damage, and I have the Steel Ward to counter, and I also have the S'more to follow up with if I pull it. Worst case scenario, I can also FFA. So this just goes through all of his res and does like 3k. Yo, I just wanted to stop the video real quick to make sure that you are subscribed to the Lost Grove channel. I upload almost every single day, and I try to stay as active as I can on my YouTube. So I'd appreciate if you guys dropped a sub, because only this amount of people are actually subscribed to my channel. So real quick, before this intermission ends, I'd appreciate if you guys could drop a sub real quick. Anyway, back to the video. Yeah, it literally did more damage than his Minnow did. He does have a lot more pips, though, obviously, so that's kind of annoying, but whatever. That's how this school goes. Let's see what he does here. So he Athena's, that's a really solid move. Well done. That was actually probably his best move. So, well played. It's overall just a really hard, like, strat to counter, man. Still does a lot through. That's unfortunate. Okay. Okay, man. Do we have a wand hit? We don't. We do have a steel ward, though. I kind of like that move. I kind of like the steel ward here. Because we get rid of the new pip. I kind of do want to pull a TC Heffy here, so I can get some damage on him and also change Bob. Okay, we pulled one. We pulled two, actually. That's perfect. We can double Heffy if you really want to. Let's see what he does here. Minnow? Athena again? Okay, sure. True combo right there. True combo right there, bro. Just say that, dude. I mean, let's see. So he's still at a ridiculous amount of HP. He's definitely ahead by a lot. I mean, I can set shield again. Right? I don't really care. What is he going to do? Blade? I'm assuming he's going to blade or Jin's defense, right? He might even weakness me. Okay, I like the vaporize a lot. I like my whole hand. I just definitely need... I'm going to get rid of this for now. Watch him literally mythic fuel this round. Okay, we got another steel ward. He just mythic fueled, didn't he? Okay, he... What? Oh, you threw, bro. You threw super hard. Now I furnace and Heffy, right? This guy literally tossed so hard just now. Because I'm gonna furnace and he's gonna immediately, let me see. Seal ward. I like my whole hand. He just tossed super hard. So I'm gonna furnace Heffy. And then Ifrit probably, if I pull it. I need to Ifrit here. Do I have a Pierce Enchant still in hand? I do have that though, I do have the S'more. Let's see what he does. I mean, he's probably just gonna weakness, right? Why wouldn't he? I'm gonna have three buffs up. I could literally just hit through a shield. Oh, he's gonna double shield. Okay, that's fine. That's perfectly fine with me. I'm just gonna heffy anyway. Sure. So again, just a really good hand. I don't really know what else I'd need. Even I think I still kill with a s'more even if he bub changes. No way I actually win this here. It's actually super winnable, that's the thing. I don't know how much a Yaga does open though. I think it would kill. 2.3, I think that's doable. Yeah, I think he would kill me with it, low-key. But I do have the pips for an Ifrit though, if I manage to pull it. I need to like just play off Steel Ward and Jin's defense until I can Ifrit or s'more. So he's gonna shield right now. I'm gonna have to Steel Ward. He's probably gonna Steel Ward a double shield or a shield back. And then I'm gonna, okay, I did pip conserve too. That's so nice. That's actually so nice, dude. And I'm probably gonna elf. Okay, yeah, so I'm gonna Steel Ward. He's gonna shield again. I'm gonna elf. I'm gonna dispel. And then I win the game, right? Let me see how much HP he has. I don't know if a single buff somewhere would even do close to that much damage, though. If he just changes Bob. We're gonna just Steel Ward. Because we have the pip conserve pips. We need to pull an Ifrit right now, dude. An Ifrit would be amazing. It would be such a good move. If he actually gives me it, right? That didn't pull it. That's unfortunate. I need the elf. He does it back and gives up a power pip for it. Oh my god, my alarm. Sorry about whoever that just triggered, bro. Somebody just got like Vietnam flashbacks from that just now. I can tell. We're kind of deck failing here. Just defense. We need to keep leveraging this big hit here. I feel like he's gonna deck fail the stun block. Or not the stun block, the steel ward. There's no way he actually pulls another one. Okay, so he just shields again, okay. Sure. So we're gonna elf, he's gonna shield our weakness. And we're gonna get the open double buffed hit. Biggest thing right now is just pulling Scimitar. I need to pull a Scimitar so I can spam shields. Okay, so the elf does a lot of extra damage too, which is super nice. So if I were him, I would just weakness right now, honestly. Oh my god, I actually pulled it. My hand's actually god. No way. Let's see what he does. So he steel wards. So I just dispel and I win, right? I just dispel some more in its game. GG, right? Hold the L. Literally hold the L. I'm pretty sure the s'more just kills. Cause yeah, the s'more easily does 4.5. Double buffed? Easily. Cause I know that OT is gonna do a lot, yeah. That OT is gonna do so much damage. Oh, he just shields again? Don't I just blade here? I didn't expect him to blade again. We're sorry, not blade, shield again. I'll just blade. I don't really care about that. I could literally just elf again and it would do enough damage to where s'more would kill. I can even Ifrit through a shield and then scorch, right? Because I already have the pierce blade. I mean, it's gonna do mass through. I can even s'more through and then scorch. If he shields again, I actually think that would be the move. Is s'more through and then scorch after. Okay, finally takes it off. I think definitely Ifrit's the move here. I think it's much safer, honestly. Ifrit's definitely the move because then nothing kills. This is a much safer move in my opinion. This does like 3.8 as well, which means Scorch automatically kills. All I need to do is just elf. Auto crit though. How much is he gonna do? Double buffed? This should do mass. Yeah, he's cooked. He's cooked. Scorch easily kills. And I have the perfect pip, so I don't have to worry about pip failing, luckily. Let's see what he does here. What does he have? Athena? Okay. Yeah, actually, I didn't even think about Athena there. Athena would have been actually probably his win con, but I have Scorch here, so it's GG. I low-key should have thought more about that, because I feel like, well, wait, I don't know if the s'more even would have killed, though. So, yeah, the s'more would have actually probably been a throw. So, GG, bro. Wow, I actually played that like a legend right there. Jesus. This kid's furious. I feel like I actually played that so well. I did not expect to turn that around on him, like, at all. Wow, I played that so well. I'm actually so super proud of myself.